I think we should start with the scores because they don't necessarily tell the top 10. Like I said, I have a top 9 as of now, so 1, 2, 3. I'm glad to see that Rush got 2 10s. Really happy about that, actually. And yeah. 1 9. Oh, we all agreed on the top performance. Yay! Did not think that was going to happen. And let's post our top 10 now. So first of all, we have top performance out of the way right away, so no problems there. Thank you, guys. I would have been so mad if they were in top performance. I mean, that is actually the best thing I have heard in this competition so far.
I see I'm the only one with Robert on my list. Oh no.
I mean, to me, he has some technical issues that I don't see as resolvable in the short amount of time that is left, unfortunately. I can already see several singers in this competition that are pretty much perfect, and he isn't one of them, unfortunately. So I have to let him go this round. Now I'm going to put together the list here to see how many yeses each person got. So here's the list. So we have 7 with 3 yeses, and then 3 with 2 yeses, and 2 with 1 yes. So if we only go by that, then we already have 10 in the 3 and 2 yes list combined. But I still haven't given my final yes. I don't know if that's going to make any difference, I guess. So no one said yes to Iggy. So then I guess my yes to Iggy wouldn't make any difference.
No, not really.
Is it because he didn't follow the theme?
No. Actually, is it? Let me look at my... Because I subtracted a single point because of the situation.
I wasn't outvoted on a single contestant here, so really happy about that, actually. But like I said, I have one yes to give still. I guess it doesn't matter at this point.
It would have.
Yes, if I gave a yes to Natasha or Robert, but they weren't a consideration to me in my scores. I still have several sevens left that I haven't given a yes to, like Emily.
If I gave that one extra point to Iggy, still wouldn't have been in the top 10 here.
No, okay. So I guess, Mark, do you have any arguments you want to give for Natasha and Trinity for Robert? And then we can see what to do about that if we want to replace someone.
Well, this is tough as trying to figure out where to make the argument for the swap.
Yeah.
Because I know where I would swap, but this hasn't gone down well in the past, so...
Well, let's hear it.
9.5, are you kidding me?
For whom?
Who do you think?
Let's see.
Who did I try and fight for a swap for last
BB.
Time?
BB. No, sorry, Mark, that's not happening.
Oh,
I can tell you right away. Not happening.
9.5, oh
yes,
my.
He added that grit and that power that is huge in a group round. He was the magic of that cover.
What, tanking a high note? Brilliant.
Oh.
Is that what the half point's there for?
Which high note did he tank?
The highest note he goes for is just wild and all over the shop.
Oh, wow.
Just super overextended. I think it might have been in the chorus. I think he might have gone on a run in the chorus and then got lost somewhere.
Yeah, well, like you see, I didn't give him a perfect score because I did hear some holes in his performance still. But I mean, I don't see me dropping him like 3 points because that's what it's gonna take. So I guess, okay, what did Trinity give him? 7.5. So I guess Trinity would be a better option for you. But don't do it, please. I need a BB in this competition.
Here's the thing. I like BB. Like I said, the only part I had an issue with was the growly bits. I don't think I'd kick him out for it.
Thank you, Trinity. Yeah, I say let's forget that idea. I love Natasha, but I can't see replacing BB with Natasha. Possibly Dream Kitu, because I don't think she nailed it this round. And she has pretty much nailed it in the past, so she's actually going backwards. Natasha is going forwards because she's showing more versatility. But at the same time, Dream Kitu has always had more dynamics than Natasha. So I don't know if I could make that swap still, if that's the route we were going to take.
Well, I guess considering that, is if you have 3 voices who are very similar to each other, I mean, Dream Kitu maybe is more familiar and more comfortable somewhere else compared to the other two she was in the group with, but they sit in fairly similar ranges. And, you know, if it's going through set genres, then you kind of have to go and fit towards the genre anyway. So my argument would be, do we take someone that is offering something a little different, which seems to be the big argument from you guys and from Andrew to keep BB around, or do we have the weakest of the three offering the same kind of thing as two others that we're thinking could probably do it better?
Hang on, who is the weakest of the three? 3. I didn't get that.
So at the bottom of the scoring of the top 10, so we've got Kat, Olivia, Dream Kitu in that order.
Yeah.
So we've got three singers who are fairly similar in terms of their approach and the range they sit in and the kind of style that they bring to the table. Is it worth keeping all three of them around to give us mainly the same thing, or do we take the top two of those and then add in a wild card that could, you know, pull off something incredible or not? I guess that's the risk, but because it's not the first time where I've argued, do we take this person or do we take this person 2.0 who's a little further on down the line?
I'm actually kind of intrigued by your arguments here, because Natasha brings something very unique to this competition. Dream Kitu has taken some major steps back this round, while Natasha actually went forward. So I want to hear Trinity's argument on that, because I'm kind of on the fence now, actually.
I really didn't like Natasha's voice, so I don't want to see her I'm sorry. Maybe it's rude, but that's that would be personally.
Oh, damn it.
Well, this is... Because I'm guessing if you don't have time to listen to all the episodes, you haven't heard her in round one and or round two.
I did listen to everyone that's in the group round. I did listen to their 2000s entries.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
Dream Kitu was my top performance last round, actually. So I'm kind of surprised that I'm even open to this. But like I said, we don't want to see someone go backwards. So I'm still open to it. So Trinity is clearly on the no side of Natasha. Mark wants to get her in over Dream Kitu, and I'm kind of on the fence because I'm a big fan of Natasha, but at the same time, overall, Dream Kitu has performed much better than Natasha, in my opinion, because Natasha has never been really dynamic to me. I mean, she has a very unique voice, but she hasn't brought in the power at any point in the competition, while Dream Kitu really impressed me last round. But we are judging on the current round first and foremost, so that would be the nail in the coffin as far as keeping Natasha in, I guess. But I gave Dream Kitu a 0.5 higher than Natasha this round still. But can Natasha get that extra point for just standing out as much as she does? That's my question here.
Well, my answer is I don't think the standing out was a good thing. So that's where I lie.
Oh, geez. This is so difficult. I really don't know what to do, honestly. And I wanted 12, so she would have been in if we had 12, definitely. So you see what happens, Mark, if you're so trigger happy. Question to you then, Mark. Do you think Natasha has the potential to give us the dynamic and that wow moment in the future? I mean, how do you see her chances of progressing in this competition as a whole?
If she does, she goes way further. If she doesn't, it was a mistake and she's probably out in the next round.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the gamble, but
yeah, so that's a big risk because we know that Dream Kitu can give us the dynamics, but at the same time, Natasha is more unique than Dream Kitu.
Unique that could win, or not so unique that may struggle against this crop.
She was my top performance last round, so it's not that far off.
Yeah, I think you're the only one on that.
Yeah, but I'm the middle one here, so my opinion kind of matters here.
I mean, one other option which might solve all this, and then we can very much say on my head be it. Mm-hmm. What's those things that ninjas throw?
Shurikens?
Yeah, not the other one though. Like something connected to this competition. Stars. Yeah, that's it. Stars. Yeah, those exist.
Okay, well, shurikens is the actual name, but okay.
All right, if we want to get sciencey with it.
Yes, we do have stars.
Darth Vader uses the death. There we go. So that's always an option. I mean, I always, and this is before I even started judging Next Top Singer and YouTube Idol and whatever, I've always had this thing for unique voices that just kind of stick in my mind. And I mean, sometimes, a lot of the time, a unique voice doesn't let me overlook technical issues, but there is this odd occasion where it does. And that's what I'm looking at here. And whether that is enough to grab a spot in the top 10, or whether that's only worthy enough for me to stick my neck out and say, yeah, let's go for it. But yeah, I think that's got to be the play. I think we leave the top 10 as it is with the three yeses and the two yeses and whatever, and then I'll throw my star towards Natasha and then we'll see what she can do.
Yeah, sounds good.
I'm sorry, Robert, I couldn't do anything for you. These two are meanies.
But
these
you
two are big ol' meanies.
You are the meanest one. You have roasted all of our contestants this round. I guess I didn't need my final yes, but last round I gave 24 yeses, so I guess it was my turn to give best yeses.
Andrea got on your case.
I don't think it would have done any difference, because those that were kind of on the fence to me didn't get a yes from you guys, so really glad that I wasn't outvoted on a single one. Did not expect that. Does anyone have anything to add?
No, I think we're good. I'm gonna have to record a star speech, aren't I?
That always happens in a group round for some reason. But group rounds are always risky, so I kind of expected that to happen. Hi guys.
Greetings.
Greetings, my child.
Oh, I know I'm probably, I am the youngest one here, but come on. You don't gotta call me child. I am an adult.
Okay, fair enough.
No, in some people's eyes, I'm still a child. I can't legally drink in America yet. Oh no.
Well, I actually had to show my ID to buy Red Bull for not that long ago. And that is 15 years old limit here in Sweden. So it was like,
oh, God.
5 years ago or something.
There's no way I'm ever gonna not get ID'd once I can drink. I got a baby face. A while ago, I was like walking by a school where there was a bunch of kids coming out, and they were all just talking to me like I was a fellow school kid, and I'm like, yeah, I graduated 2 years ago.
Okay, is everyone recording?
Yeah.
Mark?
I tell you what, I think I might have just nailed it.
Huh?
But yeah, I'm recording.
Ah, okay. So before anything crazy happens, sync time. So part one.
Right. I should have read the rules a bit again before I came in here, right?
Just say part one.
Part one.
Fantastic. That's all you need to do. It's just so that I can sync it later.
God.
So Mark, have you prepared an intro?
I have an intro.
Yay!
Also, I'll try to do something clever on the sheet to make it highlight who the top tens were in green, and it hasn't worked. So we'll just, yeah, forget I ever tried that.
No, we're going to post them at the same time here in the chat. The scores are pasted in the sheet.
Ah, okay. So we're not slapping the scores just on the sheet at the same time instead, rather than posting here? Or am I just overcomplicating it?
No, we're going to paste in the cheat at the same time and also here in the chat at the same time.
Ah, okay.
But it doesn't have to be exactly. I was just looking at the sheets. What have you done? It's all zeros.
Yeah, because when we start putting in our scores and we paste them in, it's going to start...
Ah, smart.
Tying up on the right.
Yeah.
The green thing is supposed to have just flagged up who the top 10 are, but it's not working, so I've just cancelled that.
Yeah, don't do that. But we're not going to start with the scores this time. We're going to start with the feedback part, if
okay.
That's okay, because then it is easier to edit afterwards, so that I don't have to worry about spoilers and such. Sounds good?
Sure.
Maestro, start with the intro.
Yeah, I paid attention
forward.
To the whole time.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I see how it is.
Okay, I would listen to the full episodes of some of them, of the rounds I was interested in. Some of the rounds I was not interested. I would skip the judge feedback on some people.
Mm-hmm. That's news. Okay. I see how it is.
I'm sorry. I don't have time to watch 50-minute episodes all the time.
Okay, your votes are really gonna have to make up for this. I hope you vote like me.
Oh, yeah. I definitely voted exactly like you.
No, you and Mark are so cold. I mean, you had no problem with only having 10 this round. I wanted to raise it to 12 because I can't just see letting some of these go. Group rounds are always really tough. But I have to say that this is by far my favorite group round ever.
Here's the thing. I loved his voice like through the entire song. It's just that the gritty pit was the only part I actually had an issue with. I don't know. Wow, I can talk. So yeah, I didn't like the parts where they actually sang together. Which
I don't hear you, Trindy.
Huh?
I saw you.
Oh yeah, don't worry about that. My microphone's weird on Discord. It does it sometimes.
But it's recording fine on your end.
Yes, because I'm not using my headset mic to record. Using a good microphone, the one I use for my lovely voice acting.
It's going a bit over the time limit here, but let's just keep going. And I think you have the best technique out of let's breathe. I'm a stutterer if you didn't notice. Wow.
No. Okay. Really?
Okay, shut up. Olivia, you have wonderful. You were not as solid as Damn it. You sounded a little... Okay, just need to breathe. Once I start, I can't stop. That was a journey. Are you still there, or have you fallen asleep?
No, I'm still here.
I'm surprised I haven't fallen asleep, considering I got, like, no sleep last night. Woo!
Oh.
I, like, woke up, like, half an hour before we... Actually, no, because we started late, like, an hour before.
Yeah, sorry. I'm always last minute as usual. I got invited to dinner again, but at least I have my top 9, actually. I still haven't decided on my 10th, so I guess we're gonna see how voting goes first.
Do you want the top 10, like, numbered 1 to 10, or just a list of names?
No, just the names.
Okay.
Because the placements, we don't really do placements except top performance. And everyone in the top performance is safe. Now we're going to post the scores.
Oops. Oops. Shit.
What?
Oops. Close your eyes. I accidentally hit interns.
That's fine. I didn't see it, actually, so.
Woo.
Not that it would have mattered. I stand by my choices.
I stand by, like, my top 5 choices.
Let's sort everything. Oops.
Oh, no.
Okay, and let's post our top 10 now. Ah, you already did. Who wants to do the outro? Are you there? Hello?
Yeah, I didn't know I needed
one of those.
Okay, I'm gonna do the outro then. What should I say? Okay, how do you summarize this? 112, please hold. Oh no! I accidentally called 911. What the hell?